If you take a look at my other repositories on GitHub, you will notice that in addition to HID Remapper, I also made the Flatbox. The Flatbox is a series of game controllers. They all look something like this. Currently, there's 7 major versions, and as with the HID Remapper variants, the naming scheme is very imaginative. As you can see, the Rev4 and the Rev5 versions of the Flatbox use the RP2040 chip, same as most variants of HID Remapper. I have a Rev5 Flatbox here. If we look inside it, we can see it has this WaveShare RP2040 board soldered onto the larger PCB. Since this has the same RP2040 chip that HID Remapper uses, one might wonder what would happen if we were to flash the HID Remapper firmware onto this controller. Let's not spend too much time wondering, let's just try it and see what happens. I will put the board in firmware flashing mode by holding the boot button and pressing the reset button. And I will take the firmware from the latest HID Remapper release. Let's try the regular single Pico firmware. And I will just copy it to the RPi-RP2 drive. Same as when flashing an HID Remapper with firmware, and same as any other RP2040 based device. Okay, this Flatbox is now an HID Remapper, but what does it mean? It doesn't even have a USB input port, so what can we do with it? Let's go to the HID Remapper configuration website. Let's connect to our Flatbox/HID Remapper. Then let's go to the monitor tab and start pressing buttons on the controller. As you can see, the buttons show up as GPIO inputs, and that means we can map them to something. Let's start by just making it work as a game controller again. I will set the emulated device type to say Stadia controller. Switch gamepad would work just as well in this case. And let's map some buttons. Let's do these 4. Okay, let's check the small buttons on the top. These are typically mapped to functions like select, start, and so on. As you can see, when I press this button, nothing shows up in the monitor. This is because this version of the Flatbox has this button wired to a GPIO pin that is used for the USB input port on the default HID Remapper firmware. We could, of course, compile a custom version of the firmware and make it so that this GPIO pin is available, but for now let's just ignore this one button. I think we're pretty lucky that all the other buttons happen to work. Okay, let's save this configuration. Because I changed the emulated device type, I now have to unplug and replug the controller. And let's go to a gamepad testing website. As you can see, my Flatbox is still a perfectly functional game controller, even though it's now running HID Remapper firmware. Is there any benefit to this? Wouldn't it be better to just run a dedicated game controller firmware? Well, maybe, but maybe you're used to configuring your HID Remappers using this configuration interface, and maybe you want to use the same mapping options, layers, and expressions on your game controller. And also, because this is HID Remapper, we are of course not limited to just game controllers. we can make this into a mouse or a keyboard. Let's try it. I will change the emulated device type to mouse and keyboard. And I will make it so that these four buttons move the mouse cursor. Save the configuration. Unplug and replug the controller because we changed the emulated device type. And now it works as a mouse. Of course, we could also make it work as a keyboard or maybe some kind of a macro pad, as it doesn't really have enough buttons for a regular keyboard. Okay, all of this shouldn't really be surprising. After all, a game controller like this is just a bunch of buttons wired to GPIO pins on the microcontroller, and HID Remapper can use its GPIO pins as inputs. So it's natural that this is possible. In any case, I hope you found it mildly interesting. If you have any questions, please leave a comment. Thanks for watching.